Even at 90 years of age, Yosh Uchida continues to coach the San Jose State judo team in the building that bears his name. For Uchida, judo is not just a sport, but a way to build character.
You say, what is first judo? And they say, oh, it's a gentle way. You're developing your character here. And you go academic, you go to school, you get your degree, and you graduate from here. You go out and you do well. You try to help and return to the favor of whatever you got out of the sport to the university or wherever you want. And this is the kind of thing that I think has been forgotten.
Since he took over the program in 1952, San Jose State has dominated the sport, winning 45 national titles. It's also produced more Olympians and world-class medalists than the rest of the United States combined. As a boy, Uchida took up judo as a way to get closer to his Japanese culture.
We signed up for judo because to practice kendo, it costs so darn much to get your uniform and all these helmets and things. So my parents said, well, judo doesn't cost too much, so let's go to judo.
In 1940, he enrolled at San Jose State and taught judo at the university's police school. But then World War II intervened. While Uchida served in the Army Medical Corps, his mother and father were sent to an internment camp in Poston, Arizona. Ironically, the building which was named after him was used to process his parents. Once the war ended, he returned to San Jose State to teach judo. The 5'2" Uchida remembers being challenged by a football player.
He started swinging me around, and after a couple of swings, I was horizontal to the mat. He said, now what are you going to do? Well, I decided, I just kept quiet, and I just let him do that because I knew that eventually he would have to let me down, and at that moment, he's going to be off balance, so I waited for that one moment, and he did let me down at that one moment. As my feet touched the mat, I went into action and I threw him. And of course, then I turned around to the class and said, "This is judo," and that was the end of it. I had no problems after that.
In 1953, Uchida worked with Cal coach Henry Stone to get judo recognized as a sport. The two later came up with a weight class system, which led to it being accepted by the Olympics. At the Tokyo Games in 1964, Uchida would serve as the U.S. judo coach. While the sport was gaining acceptance, Uchida still remembers the sting of anti-Japanese sentiment following the war.
We were sort of second-rate, looked down on in 1940s, 50s. Nobody will sell to you. And the real estate agent, if they sold to you, really got in trouble. He got pulled before the board, and they'd take his license away. The treatment that we received as a Japanese or Asians or whatever, I think that made me sort of wanna get out there and push harder.
When he wasn't coaching, Uchida found time to get a degree in biology. He was soon testing blood for local doctors.
So 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, they would call and I'd chug along. I had a jalopy and I'd chug to the hospital and draw the blood, do the testing for them. And so they would go into surgery and they said, well, Yosh, you doing anything? I said, no. He said, well, why don't you come up and watch me do surgery? I said, oh, okay. So I got to know some of these doctors. So when I started my own business, they were very helpful.
His business blossomed, and in 1989, he sold it to Unilab for $31 million. With the money, he opened Uchida Enterprises, which includes a travel agency. He also invested millions into developing San Jose's Japantown, like Morito Village, a retail apartment complex which opened in 1995. Because judo is not an NCAA sport, it receives no school funding, so Uchida holds an annual golf tournament to raise money for the program.
What would you like people to think of when they think of Yosh Uchida?
Well, you could say that he really thought a lot of San Jose State and tried to expand the judo and better judo at all times.
Uchida has given his life to judo, and he's not done yet.